Hi, welcome to this lab. In this lab, I'm going to show you how to create Cosmos DB account and create a collection within it and add an item into it and finally go through some of the settings associated with Cosmos DB account. So first of all, let's create Cosmos DB account. Search for Cosmos and then click on Azure Cosmos DB. Click on create. And then here I'm going to select resource group databases RG, and I'm going to provide an account name, Rudra Cosmos, and API. You can select number of APIs. So as you can see, you can select for MongoDB, Cassandra, Azure Table, etc. But I'm going to select CoreSQL, and I'm going to deploy in Northwest. And you can enable geo-redundancy. When you enable geo-redundancy, a replica will get created in the paid region, okay? And you can allow or disable multi-region writes. I'm going to enable and then click on next. Here, you can specify the virtual network from which you want to accept the connections, but I'm not going to do that at this moment of time. I'm going to just create it. Now, this is going to take some time because we enabled geo-redundancy also, and also read and writes on all regions. So I'm going to pause this video for a few minutes until this deployment is successful. Now our Cosmos DB deployment has been successfully completed. So let's go to the resource. First thing we are going to do is to add a database. So in order to do that, go to Data Explorer and let's create a database. You need to create a database before you can add a collection, okay? Here, I'm going to call this as Rudra database. And one thing you need to remember is you can provision throughput at two levels. One is at a database level. If you provision throughput at a database level, all the collections under the database will share the resources. Okay, I'm not going to provision throughput here. I'm going to provision the throughput at a collection level. Generally, it is very quick. So let's wait for it. So now we have created a database. And now let's add a collection to it. I'm going to use existing. Come on, let me type in Rudra database. Maybe because it is Safari, it's not getting displayed. Ideally, it should be displayed here. And the collection ID, let's say collection one. And what will be the partition key? Let's say country, okay? And throughput, I'm going to select the minimum. So you can define the throughput here and also at a database level if you want, but I'm doing that at a collection level and click on OK. Now we created a collection. So let's click on it. Now, as you can see, you can have documents, store procedures, user defined functions, triggers, etc. But at this moment of time, we will add a document. Let's click on new. ID, I'm going to make it as one, and I'm going to do only one additional thing, which is country. Okay, and then save. And that will add a document into this collection. And you can see a lot of system generated values. In case if you want more information about these, just refer to Microsoft documentation, where there is a detailed explanation about what is this each system property is all about. Anyway, I'm going to add a link to the resource section of this lecture. Click on it and go through that. And the next thing I want to show you is scale and settings. In case if you want to change the throughput that is allocated for this collection at a later point of time, you can change it here. And also conflict resolution. In case if there is a conflict when a record is getting updated by two users, what is the mode that you want to follow in terms of conflict when they both edit the same record, okay? And the next thing is time to leave. This is very important. In case if you want to delete items from this collection after certain period of time, so for example, you have added a document and you haven't accessed it for a year. And if you want to have an auto deletion, basically after 1 year from last access or last modified, then you can provide a time to live here and define what is the time scale. So let's say if a record is not updated or accessed in the last, 30 days, you want to get it deleted automatically, then you can define here. Okay. And you can define stored procedures, user defined function, triggers. If you go to the top, you can start creating all those stuff here. But it is extremely unlikely you will create a document using Azure portal. In a real world scenario, you will have IoT applications, gaming applications, retail marketing applications, and those applications programmatically will add documents into this collection. So it is extremely unlikely that you will use Azure portal, in my view. And if you come down here, you can see number of things. First is replicate data globally. Here you can add multiple other regions also. So it is still updating, but what you get is here is a plus sign. You just click on it. That means you automatically added the regions where read and write replica needs to be created. And if you come back here, default consistency. There are 5 consistency level as I explained in theory lecture. You can select any one of them. Because the data is globally distributed and replicated, it is very important that you identify the right consistency that is suited for your needs. And finally, you can click on firewalls and networks, where you can configure some firewall rules. Basically, you can specify the IP addresses from where you want to accept the connections, and also virtual networks from where you want to accept the connections. Okay. And you can do a lot of other things, which I will take you through later. But these are the fundamental stuffs that you need to know about Azure Cosmos DB account. So that's it for this lab. In this lab, I have shown you how to create Cosmos DB account, and also using Data Explorer, we have created a database, and under a database, we have created a collection, and for that collection, we have added a throughput, basically 400 RUs. And under that collection, we have added a document, and I have gone through some scale and settings also. But fundamentally, you will use APIs, whether it is REST APIs or .NET libraries. Those are the stuff you will use in order to modify or insert documents into this Cosmos DB. You will not use Azure portal. I hope you find this lab useful.